बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलामुअलैकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, क्लास नाइन्थ बायोलॉजी। आज हम चैप्टर नंबर 4 सेल्स एंड टिश्यूज़ का लास्ट टॉपिक प्लांट टिश्यूज़ डिस्कस करेंगे। द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज़ हाउ मैनी कैटेगरीज आर काइंड ऑफ प्लांट टिश्यूज़ आर। देर आर टू मेजर कैटेगरीज ऑफ प्लांट टिश्यूज़, वन इज सिंपल एंड द अदर इज कंपाउंड टिश्यू।
द फर्स्ट काइंड ऑफ प्लांट टिश्यूज इज सिंपल टिश्यूज। द क्वेश्चन इज व्हाट आर सिंपल टिश्यूज, हाउ मैनी काइंड ऑफ सिंपल टिश्यूज आर। द टिश्यूज विच आर मेड अप ऑफ सिंगल टाइप ऑफ सेल्स आर कॉल्ड सिंपल टिश्यूज एंड दे आर ऑफ टू टाइप्स, meristematic tissues and permanent tissues. The next question is meristematic tissues. Those tissues which have ability to divide are called meristematic tissues. How many types of meristematic tissues are? There are two types of meristematic tissues. One is apical meristem and other is lateral meristem. What are apical meristems? These are located at the tips of root and shoot. What is primary growth? If tissues or cells divide and cause increase in length, such growth is called primary growth. What are lateral meristems? Those meristems which are located on the lateral sides of roots and shoot. What is secondary growth? When lateral meristems divide, they are responsible for increase in growth of plant parts. Such growth is called secondary growth. How many types of lateral meristems are? Lateral meristems are of two types, vascular cambium and cork cambium. What is intercalary meristem? Intercalary meristem is in the form of small patches among the mature tissues. These are common in grasses and help in the regeneration of parts removed by herbivores. The next kind is permanent tissue. What are permanent tissues? Permanent tissues originate from meristematic tissue. These cells have lost the ability to divide. The next one is epidermal tissues. Epidermal tissues are composed of a single layer of cells and they form the covering of plant body. What is the function of epidermal tissue? Epidermal tissue act as a barrier between environment and internal plant tissues. As well in roots, they are responsible for the absorption of water and minerals. And the third is on stem and leaves, they secrete cutene. What is the function of cutene? Cutene prevents evaporation. The MCQs may be permanent tissues originate from meristematic tissue. Permanent tissues don't have ability to divide. Epidermal tissues are composed of a single layer of cells and they form the covering of plant body. The coating of cutene is called cuticle. Epidermal tissues are specialized for special functions. Root hairs and stomata are the examples of permanent tissues. The next topic is ground tissues. What are ground tissues? Ground tissues are simple tissues which are made up of parenchyma cells. What are parenchyma cells? Parenchyma cells are the most abundant cells in plants. They are spherical but flat at point of contact. What is the function of parenchyma cells? In leaves, they are called mesophyll cells and involved in the process of photosynthesis, while in some other parts, they are involved in respiration and protein synthesis. The MCQs may be: ground tissues are made up of parenchyma cells. The most abundant cells in plants are parenchyma cells. Parenchyma cells have thin primary cell wall. Mesophyll cells are responsible for photosynthesis. The next question is, what do you know about the ability of division of parenchyma cells? Most parenchyma cells can develop the ability to divide and differentiate into other types of cells, and they do so during the process of repairing and injury. What are spore tissues? Spore tissues are those tissues which provide strength and flexibility to plants. What are colenchyma cells? Colenchyma cells are found in cortex of young stems and in the midrib of leaves and in the petals of flowers. What kind of cells are present in colenchyma cells? They are made up of elongated cells with unevenly thickened primary cell walls. What is the function of colenchyma tissues? Colenchyma tissue is for supporting the organs in which they are found. The MCQs may be: spore tissues provide strength as well as flexibility to plants. Spore tissues are of two types. Colenchyma cells are present in cortex, and cortex is present beneath epidermis. Colenchyma cells are flexible. What do you know about sclerenchyma tissues? Sclerenchyma tissues are composed of cells with rigid secondary cell walls. Their hardness is due to the presence of lignin, and mature sclerenchyma cells cannot elongate and most of them are dead. Sclerenchyma tissues have cells with rigid secondary cell walls. Lignin is the main chemical component of wood. The next topic is compound tissues. What are compound or complex tissues? A plant tissue composed of more than one type of cells is called a compound or complex tissue. Xylem and phloem tissues are found in vascular plants are examples of compound tissues. What are xylem tissues? Those tissues which are responsible for the transport of water and dissolved substances from roots to aerial parts are called xylem tissues. What kind of cells are present in xylem tissues? There are two types of cells. One is vessel elements and other is tracheids. What are vessel elements? Vessel elements have thick secondary cell walls They lack end walls and join together to form long tubes. While tracheids are slender cells with overlapping ends. What are complex tissues? They are composed of more than one type of cells. Xylem tissue is responsible for the transport of water and dissolved substances. Lignin is present in the secondary walls of xylem tissues. Xylem tissues also provide support. Xylem tissues are of two types, vessel elements and tracheids. And the last tissues which we shall discuss today are phloem tissue. Phloem tissue is responsible for the conduction of dissolved organic matter or food between different parts of plant body. What kind of cells are present in phloem tissues? Phloem tissues have sieve tube cells and companion cells. What are sieve tube cells? They are long and their end walls have small pores. They form long sieve tubes by joining sieve tube cells. Companion cells are responsible for making protein for the sieve tube cells. MCQs may be, phloem tissue is responsible for the conduction of dissolved organic matter. Sieve tube cells are long and their end walls have small pores. Companion cells make protein for sieve tube cells. All the plant tissues may also be selected as a long question in the examination. So, dear students, we have discussed today the plant tissues, which is the ending topic of chapter number 4, cells and tissues. Next time we shall discuss chapter number 5, inshallah. Till then, Allah Hafiz.